So what's going on, guys? It's the King 777 HD here, and welcome to top 10 silver players that I'm really, really looking forward to use in FIFA 15, and the players I also recommend you to try out in this year's FIFA Ultimate Team. So the first player we're going to take a look at is going to be Carlos Pena, and he is one of the best youngsters in Mexico at the moment, and he has been just really, really solid in the league. And apparently, I think he messed up his World Cup because he managed to get himself an injury. So that's why he also managed to get downgraded. But he's a very, very good talent in Mexico. And he got some incredible in-game stats as well, with 90 stamina, 86 strength, 83 sprint speed, 81 jumping, 71 long shot, and 71 standing tackle. So some ridiculously good stats. Very, very all-rounded player. And he's like a silver. Yeah. Torre, definitely a very, very, very good and very solid looking player this year for the Ultimate Team. Next player is going to be the only non-rare player in this team, and that is Antonio Rudiger. There's actually quite a few of very good players, non-rare silver players, which have not been too many in last year for the Ultimate Team, but this year there are actually a few very nice non-rare silvers. And this guy looks one of the best of them, in my opinion. And Antonio Rudiger got 80 pace, 73 defending, and 77 physical. He got some ridiculous stats for a non-rare silver centre-back. And in my opinion, should be definitely be a GOAT. And he got some nice in-game stats as well. 84 aggression, 84 sprint speed, 70 strength, 79 strength, 75 standing tackle, and 69 power control, which is very, very good for a silver centre-back. And looks like a very solid center back, just as this guy, Mobido Diakite. And he was one of my favorite gold center backs last year. He was just ridiculously good, was really, really fast, had incredible strength, he was really, really strong, got incredible jumping and heading as well, and was very, very good defensively. But this year managed to get himself a downgrade to a 74 rated centre back, and that is not a surprise because he had been really, really bad for Sunderland pretty much whole season. Now we move to Liga BBVA, to Deportivo, I think is the name of this team, I'm not sure, but he got some ridiculous in-game stats with 86 jumping, still got very high strength and jumping, booth 86, 81 sprint speed, 78 standing tackle, and 76 sliding tackle. So some ridiculous looking stats for a center back, and really looking forward to use him in this year Ultimate Team, just as this guy Thomas Hubokan. And look at the stats of a silver center back, they look simply incredible. And Kolodin and Kokorin, I think it's Kolodin, this incredible center back from Russia with over 80 long shot, I think at 86 long shot. He's not in this year Ultimate Team for some reason, and this guy, in my opinion, going to be a ridiculously good replacement for him, because this guy have got 90 jumping, 85 shot power, 80 standing tackle, 79 sprint speed, and 79 long shots. So this guy got some incredible stats for a center back, with very high defensive stats, very good pace for a center back, and also great long shot and shooting in general. So going to be a ridiculously expensive center back as well, because he's playing the Russian league, and Russian league teams looks very, very overpowered this year. So they might get a huge comeback this year, and this guy definitely going to be a very popular center back for silver Russian teams, because he just got incredible stats and looks like a fantastic center back to use in the Zero Ultimate Team. Next player is going to be Juan Camilo Zuniga, one of the most controversial players in the World Cup, as he injured Neymar during the World Cup, but nevertheless, he looks like an incredible left back for Serie A teams. Used to be a left midfielder in FIFA 14, 78 rated left midfielder. Now he moved to a left back, and he managed to get himself a downgrade to a 73 rated card, which I think is a position change. I don't really think he managed to get the downgrades, because he was actually playing really, really solid. And I mean, he wasn't playing that much, but I don't really think he was that bad to actually get himself downgrade, especially after the very good World Cup. He was very solid for Colombia, in my opinion, and he looks like a fantastic left back. Very going to be used in the 3-5-2 as well as a left winger back, because he got a lot of great stats suited for attacking player. 89 agility, 79 dribbling, 75 standing and sliding tackle, 70 shot power and 70 long shots. Looks like a very, very good left back, a very attacking one as well, but very solid defensive one, and looks like probably one of the best left backs. Also the 4-star skills. And the next player is going to be the player that I look most forward to be using in this year ultimate team. One of my favorite players in real life, one of my favorite players from MODA, is going to be Mohamed Elneny, and you guys pretty much know I'm a MODA supporter. I really love this team, and this guy, one of the biggest talent in the team, and in my opinion, he's currently better than his cousin, better than Tariq Elneny, and in my opinion, they should have switch up ratings, because Tariq wasn't playing that much last season, he wasn't really that good, and Mohamed Elneny was simply incredible, had such a big impact on MODA, and now he scored also quite a bit of goals in the new season start, so in my opinion, he should be getting a very nice upgrade next year. This year, though, looks pretty solid. It's 84 acceleration, 83 agility, 79 dribbling, 69 finishing and 60 free accuracy. Some of these stats should be higher, but in my opinion, it looks like a very solid silver card, and I'm definitely going to use him. Also, the 5-star skills look simply incredible, and the 5-star skills are so well deserved for him, because he definitely deserved that. He's very skilled from real life, just as this guy Shikabala, going to be a ridiculously good left winger in this year's ultimate team, because he's silver. He got 83 sprint speed, 78 dribbling, 78 shot power, 75 volley, 73 long shot. I also got 72 strength, and strength and dribbling is going to be a very, very important factor in this year's ultimate team. So this guy looks like a very, very good card this year, going to be really, really solid and very interesting to use in hybrids, because he got the perfect stats in my opinion for a FIFA 15 hidden gem player, and also he got the 5-star skills, which he deserves a lot, because he is a very skillful player. He's like an Egyptian Cristiano Ronaldo. There's a lot of skill moves, score great goals, a great long shot, and very, very skillful and agile player in real life. So going to be great. And the number 3 is going to probably one of the best lucky strikers this year is going to be Luciano Vietto. There are a lot of great strikers. There is Muriel, who looks incredible, very sweaty. There are a lot of great strikers, but this guy just blew me away, because he got 77 shooting on a silver striker, which is simply incredible, and I have no idea how on earth he is not a gold player. Should be a gold in my opinion, with 77 shooting, 82 pace, 75 dribbling, 70 passing, with also 78 long shot, 78 finishing, 76 dribbling and 80 shot power. In my opinion, definitely should be a gold card, but in this year's ultimate team, going probably one of the best and one of the most overpowered silver strikers this year. And now number 2, and this is going to be probably one of the most overpowered and one of the best low rated silver cards this year, going to be another Tifchi. 5-star skill moves. He used to be an incredible bronze striker last year, but now he looks like an insane and really overpowered silver striker with 83 pace and 90 strength, also combined with 5-star skills, going to be ridiculously fun to use in ultimate team. Also the link he got with Makai Steven, another 5-star skill, are going to be simply ridiculous and very overused this year in all the silver teams. Also got 80 shot power, 80 agility, 70 finishing that he's going to have in game. I think that's 69 normally, 84 sprint speed, so he looks like a ridiculous player. But number 1, the player I look most forward to using this year with Ultimate Team, in my opinion, the best looking silver card this year is going to be Mikel Arroyo. Look at these stats, over 73 rated left winger, looks incredible. 88 pace, 74 shots, 75 dribbling, with also 74 physical, which is incredible. These are some incredible stats on a 73 rated guard. 83 acceleration also as well, 82 shot power, 78 long shots, 77 dribbling and 74 strength. Incredible in-game stats. Used to be a great striker in the World Cup mode last year with 4-star skills and some ridiculously good stats as well for a 70 rated card, but now he looks like an absolute monster, going to be just ridiculous in this year with the mid team. It looks simply incredible, and the link he also got with Ronaldinho and Fido Martinez going to be ridiculously good for hybrids as well. So these have been the top 10 silver players I look forward to use most in the ultimate team. Hope you enjoyed. Thank you so much guys also for the great support I got on the my last FIFA 14 edit. Overall, your support have been simply incredible, and I see you next time guys. Peace.